Hey friends, it's Corey from Hey Let's Make Stuff. Today's quick tutorial will show you the best ways to fit more on your Cricut mat. This is a great way to help you save materials and have fewer scraps. So often when you go to make your project in Cricut Design Space, the software will lay out your image on the Cricut mat in the way that it thinks is best to save the most amount of material. The problem is, it's not particularly good at this. But Cricut knows this, so they've given users three tools to help you fit more on a Cricut mat so you can save material. So here I have a feather on my Cricut mat. If I go up here to make it, and for this project, I'm just gonna choose on mat. Now, if I wanted to make 10 of these feathers, I can change that up here in project copies, and then it will lay out these feathers on the Cricut mat in the way it thinks is best. And obviously, this is not the best. We can save a lot of material here. You'll see that it has rotated a couple of these feathers on the bottom to try and save a little bit more space, but then you have two feathers that are on a second mat. This is because each image has a rectangular bounding box around it, and the software can't overlap these bounding boxes automatically. So we can use some of the tools in Cricut Design Space to help us save this material. The first one is the Move tool. This is a simple tool. All you have to do is click on each image and you can move it closer here. So you can see here that I can actually fit four feathers all the way across. And then I can tuck these other feathers here underneath the other feathers and save quite a bit of material. So there we have it. We've got these all tucked up nicely, and this will save us a ton of space. Next is the Rotate tool. So we have these two feathers down here on the bottom. If you click on the tool, you can actually use this little Rotate tool to rotate the feather any direction. If you hold down the Shift key, it will rotate it at certain intervals, which is helpful. So I rotated it all the way around, and now I can tuck these two up here as well, just like this. All right, we've already saved ourselves a massive amount of space, but we do have these two feathers on this second mat. That's where the third tool comes in handy. So if you click these three dots here, you can say Move Object, and then you can select another Cricut mat to move your file to. So I'm gonna go ahead and move it to this other mat, and it will put it right on top, so then you'll need to drag it here. And then you can do the same with the other one. Click the little dots, click Move Object, choose the other mat, and confirm. And again, you can just drag it down here. Now you can see how much material we have saved. Not only are we only using a single mat worth of material, there's also quite a bit extra material here. You could put more feathers, or you can use this as another scrap for another project, but it has saved us a significant amount of material. I hope you found this very quick walkthrough of these three tools helpful. They can save you so much material in the long run. I use them on almost every project. If you have any questions about the Move tool, the Rotate tool, or the Move to another mat tool, just leave them in the comments and I'll be happy to answer them. If you have any other tricks you love for saving materials, I would love to hear those in the comments as well. If you found this video helpful, give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more weekly content. I'll see you next week.